Should you go for an aftermarket high-performance CPU cooler, or would your old reliable stock cooler suffice? A question that has been more or less unanswered, or just generated more confusion regarding which one to go for, has been finally taken into consideration, as in our video today, we're going to talk about whether we really need to spend that extra cash on an aftermarket cooler, or rely on the stock cooler itself. Let's explore the differences, pros and cons, and determine when an aftermarket cooler might be worth the investment. Let's start with the basics. Stock coolers are the basic cooling solutions that come pre-installed with most CPUs. They're designed to provide adequate cooling for the average user, handling everyday tasks, and even some light gaming. While stock coolers may not be the most powerful or aesthetically pleasing, they're functional and cost-effective. After all, CPU manufacturers wouldn't include them if they couldn't keep your processor within safe temperature limits. On the other hand, aftermarket coolers are third-party cooling solutions designed to provide superior cooling performance compared to stock coolers. They come in various forms, from air coolers with massive heat sinks and high-quality fans to all-in-one liquid coolers with water blocks and radiators. Aftermarket coolers are engineered to handle even the most demanding workloads, making them an attractive option for enthusiasts and overclockers. Some stock coolers, like AMD's Wraith Prism, can even hold their own against mid-range aftermarket coolers, blurring the lines between the two.
Are you struggling to explain your idea? Your audience is not getting what you're trying to say. An animated explainer video is a perfect solution for you. Explainer video simplifies any complex ideas through engaging animations, transitions, voiceovers, and meaningful scripts, which all together create a fun experience for any viewer. And here comes 10 Studio, a team of skilled professionals dedicated to creating engaging explainer videos. With over thousands completed projects, we have the expertise to create explainer videos that break down your message and connect with your audience. Get in touch with 10 Studio today.
Both stock and aftermarket coolers bring their own set of advantages to the table. Stock coolers excel in simplicity. They're easy to install and are designed to work seamlessly with the specific CPU they're bundled with, eliminating any compatibility issues or risk of voiding warranties due to improper installation. Additionally, their budget-friendly nature allows users to allocate more of their budget towards a higher-tier CPU or other components that can significantly impact overall performance. On the flip side, aftermarket coolers offer several advantages over stock coolers. They typically run quieter due to their larger, more efficient fans and heat sinks, allowing for lower fan speeds and reduced noise levels. They also provide better thermal performance, keeping your CPU cooler under load and potentially extending its lifespan. Aftermarket coolers open up the possibility of overclocking, allowing enthusiasts to push their CPU beyond its base clock speeds for even more performance. Additionally, many aftermarket coolers boast unique designs and RGB lighting, adding a touch of visual flair to the overall build. While stock coolers can suffice for most users, they do have their limitations. They're not designed for overclocking or heavy workloads like video rendering or other CPU-intensive tasks. Under such conditions, stock coolers may struggle to keep temperatures under control, leading to thermal throttling, which reduces performance. Additionally, stock coolers tend to be noisier than aftermarket options due to their smaller fans and heat sinks. On the other hand, while aftermarket coolers offer superior cooling performance, they come with their own set of downsides. The most obvious is the added cost. With decent air coolers starting around $50 and AIO liquid coolers costing even more. Compatibility can also be a concern, as you'll need to ensure the cooler fits your CPU socket and case dimensions. Improper installation can potentially void warranties or even damage components. Finally, larger air coolers and radiators for AIO liquid coolers may conflict with other components, such as tall RAM modules or expansion cards. It's crucial to consider these potential drawbacks, alongside the benefits when deciding between a stock or aftermarket cooler. So, when is an aftermarket cooler a necessity? For most users who stick to basic tasks and light gaming, a stock cooler will suffice. However, if you plan to overclock your CPU, an aftermarket cooler is almost essential. overclocking increases heat output significantly, and a more robust cooling solution is necessary to maintain stability and longevity. Additionally, if you engage in CPU-intensive tasks like video rendering or image processing, an aftermarket cooler can help prevent thermal throttling and ensure optimal performance. If you've decided an aftermarket cooler is the way to go, it's essential to choose the right one for your system. Consider your case dimensions, CPU socket compatibility, and noise level preferences. Air coolers like the Noctua NHD15 or Cooler Master Hyper 212 offer reliable performance at a modest price, but may conflict with other components due to their size. AIO liquid coolers from brands like EVGA or Corsair provide excellent cooling, but require careful consideration of radiator and fan placement. Read customer and expert reviews to identify any potential quirks or compatibility issues before making your purchase. While stock coolers are sufficient for most users, an aftermarket cooler can offer significant benefits in terms of cooling performance, noise levels, and overclocking potential. However, the decision to upgrade should be based on your specific use case and budget. If you're a casual user or gamer, stick with the stock cooler and consider investing in a higher tier CPU instead. But if you're an enthusiast or engage in CPU intensive tasks, an aftermarket cooler can be a worthwhile investment. Just be sure to choose one that fits your system and aligns with your preferences for cooling, noise, and aesthetics. Remember, a well-cooled CPU is the foundation of a stable and high-performing system, so make an informed decision that suits your unique needs.